It's caught. Westbrook for the touchdown. Minshew improvising again.
So fun to watch. A glimpse of hope, certainly, to end the Jags season. The team crushed the Indianapolis Colts in the final game of the decade, in case you missed it, 38-20. One major development we saw yesterday, improvements on both sides of the ball. Oh, what a relief. News for Jags sports analyst Mark Brunell joins me now in today's Monday morning quarterback segment. Good morning. Thank you for being here. Okay, because we don't see a lot of wonderful highlights, let's just look back before we look ahead.
Okay, all that right? sounds good.
So first of all, Minshew, some missed opportunities kind of early on in the game, but hey, a win is a win is a win, right? So we're not going to complain.
A win is a win. The sixth round pick was 6-6 as a starter. Listen, he played really well for a young player to come in essentially on a bad football team and to get six wins and play with the way he plays, the toughness, the grit, the moxie, he has all of that. I think everyone could be excited about Gardner Minshew.
Do you think he needs to be then the QB moving forward?
I think he's earned the right to be the QB going into the offseason. Now, whether there'll be an open competition in training camp, that's up to Doug Marrone if he's still the head coach or the next head coach, whatever. But I think going into the offseason right now, he's the starter.
So the defense has really, has many people have been critical, right? So let's give a little praise here this morning, shall we? Calais Campbell picking up that fumble, running it in for the TD. Right. That was so fun to watch yesterday.
How much do we love Calais Campbell? He's a great guy and a good player. He's had an incredible career. I hope he's here next year. He's just good in the locker room. He's great in the community. He's a good leader. He's everything you want in a veteran player. But he's getting older. We're paying him a lot of money. But I hope he stays. We'll see how it works out.
And talking about that, Yannick Ngakoue, we saw yesterday. Of course, he helped with that fumble, right, yesterday?
Yep.
But we saw him doing the show me the money on the sidelines. Oh, Lord.
There it is right there. Show him the money. The Jaguars, in my opinion, really have to. He has produced. He's a young player that is playing with a lot of passion, just simply making plays. Give that kid a big contract. And let's go forward. Let him be here, be a Jaguar for the rest of his career.
And talk about a lot of money. Chris Conley, one catch will do it. 17-yard catch, right? $125,000 bonus
now? Not a bad day. Not a bad day at the office. So good for him. And you know what? Another great guy. He's been great for Gardner Minshew. A good addition to this football team this year. I just like it. I like when guys that work hard, play well, good team guys, they go out there and they produce and get compensated.
And he is a favorite, it seems, certainly for Minshew.
Oh,
all right, let's look ahead.
Okay.
Heard some mixed signals, certainly, as we've reported with Coach Marrone. You know, Shad Khan says that he wants to have a midweek meeting. What do you think?
Well, I think that, listen, last year we were 5-11. This year we were 6-10. A year ago, the owner came out and said, listen, if things are the same, you know, in 2019, we have to make changes. Well, they are the same. But I'm hearing, I think a lot of people are hearing, Jen, that things are going to stay the same, that Doug Marrone and Dave Caldwell will survive this, that they will get to keep their jobs going forward. I think most fans would probably not like to hear that, but the feeling is right now that there won't be any more changes, but we'll see.
You know, from the fan, so it was split in my household yesterday.
Oh,
there were about
it?
10
okay.
of us watching. You know, some feel that this, look, let's start anew.
Mm-hmm.
But some others feel with Tom gone, that maybe that's enough of a change.
Well, it's interesting because really all the success that the Jaguar franchise has had over the last 25 years, Tom Coughlin has been a part of
right.
it. Three AFC championship games. You know what? Tom Coughlin was there. So if you think getting rid of Tom Coughlin is going to fix everything, that's not the case. I like that the team played for Doug yesterday. I like that it's a close team. But that's all great when you're a team that's going to the playoffs. I don't care who likes who and how well everyone gets along. This is a results business. You've got to win football games, and this organization has not won football games the last 2 years. In my opinion, and this is nothing personal, but it's time for a change. With change brings some hope and some optimism, a new feeling around here. But if things stay the same, I think most people, including myself, would be a little disappointed.
It's interesting, too, because I was noticing that there were not a lot of fans in the stands yesterday.
Right.
I know it's a holiday weekend, don't get me wrong, but, you know, right. Shad Khan wants to fill the stands.
Right? Yes, he does.
It is a business at the end of the day.
It's going to be an interesting week. Either way, you know, Shad Khan, this is his decision. And But we'll see. Could hear something today. Could be midweek. But it will be big news either way.
We'll certainly been following it. And yep. I know you'll be following
Absolutely.
It tonight also with Culpepper, who will join Mark for the Mark Brunell Show at Sneakers in Jacksonville Beach at 7 o'clock, which you can also watch, by the way, live on CW17.